Welcome students in online class for the subject physics for 11th standard. Today we learn chapter number 1, units and measurements. In this chapter we have seen physical quantities, different types, units, different systems and SI units. So first of all we can see physical quantity. So we know that what is physical quantity. See here, any quantity like length, mass, time, displacement, force, etc. Any quantity which can be measured is called physical quantity. Example, length, mass, time, velocity, volume, etc. Another form of physical quantity will be a physical property. A physical property, properties of matter, radiation or interaction among them can be subjected equally to all three elements of scientific study, named as number 1, detail analysis, number 2, precise measurement, and number 3, mathematical treatment. Means any quantity which can be measured is called physical quantity, or a physical properties of matter, radiation or interaction among them can be subjected equally to all three elements of scientific study, named as detail analysis, precise measurement and mathematical treatment, called physical quantity. And we give an example: length, mass, time, velocity, volume, force, acceleration, etc. These are the physical quantities. Again, we have seen यूनिट ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी. सो इन दिस यूनिट, सो फर्स्ट व्हाट इज मीन बाय यूनिट ऑफ द क्वांटिटी और व्हाट इज मीन बाय यूनिट. यूनिट इज और यूनिट ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी इज डिफाइंड एज a standard which is used for measurement. Means a standard which is used for measurement is called unit of physical quantity. Okay, so here it is a standard which can be used or a standard which can be compared or a standard of measurement which can compare so is called compare the physical quantities called unit of physical quantities. Okay, then these measurement of physical quantities, it is the process. See here, in measurement of physical quantities, here in this type we can see it is the process which process it is the process of measurement. Which consists of or to find how many times a unit is measured of that physical quantity. Is called measurement of physical quantity. If we can measure a physical quantity, the value of measurement of physical quantity is expressed as nu, where n is numeric like 1, 2, 3, 4 ... and u is unit of that physical quantity. It is measurement of physical quantity. Suppose if we can see an example, a length of rod इज 3.00 सेंटीमीटर, मीन्स रॉड इज 3.00 टाइम्स एज लॉन्ग एज द स्टैंडर्ड यूनिट ऑफ लेंथ. सपोज इफ वी कैन सी लेंथ ऑफ रॉड इज 3.00 मीटर, इट मीन्स रॉड इज 3.00 टाइम्स एज लॉन्ग एज द स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ यूनिट एज मीटर. As meter, and the magnitude of physical quantity will be, it is number of times a standard quantity or physical quantity is present in a given physical quantity. Okay, so we can write as physical quantity that is equal to its magnitude multiplied by unit. So we say that length of rod will be 3.00 meter, means 3.00 is magnitude of physical quantity like length. Okay, some characteristics can be seen for standard unit. So, a question will be asked, what are the characteristics for a standard unit? So, first of all, we write, unit should not change with respect to space or place, comma, time and environmental condition. That is the characteristics for standard unit. Means unit should be invariable, means unit should not change from time or from place to another place. Second, unit should be easily, accurately reproducible, means unit should be reproduced easily and accurately. Third characteristics will be unit of that physical quantity should accept universally. Means anywhere, any place, unit should accept universally. Fourth, unit should be well defined. Unit should be well defined. Means unit for mass. It will be same any country. That cannot be changed in time, environmental condition as well as place. These are the characteristics for standard unit. Again, we can see the types of physical quantities. Physical quantities. See here, there are three types of physical quantities are there. Number one, fundamental quantity or fundamental physical quantity. Number two will be derived physical quantity. And number three, it will be supplementary physical quantity. These physical quantities will be seen one by one. So first of all, we have determined or we have find fundamental physical quantity. So question will be, what is mean by fundamental quantity or what is mean by fundamental physical quantity? It is a quantity which is independent on another physical quantity. Another way we can express as, it is a physical quantity which do not depends on another physical quantity. Such quantity is called as, such quantity will be said as fundamental physical quantity. So here example will be length, mass, time, electric current, temperature, luminous intensity. And amount of substance. Means सेवन फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज आर इंक्लूडिंग इन फंडामेंटल क्वांटिटी. दिस फंडामेंटल क्वांटिटी इज ऑल्सो, इट कैन बी ऑल्सो मेजर्ड डायरेक्टली, सो कॉल्ड एज बेसिक क्वांटिटी. बेसिक क्वांटिटी. सो क्वेश्चन विल बी आस्क व्हाट इज बेसिक क्वांटिटी. सो बेसिक क्वांटिटी मीन्स अ फंडामेंटल फिजिकल क्वांटिटी विच डज नॉट डिपेंड्स ऑन अनदर फिजिकल क्वांटिटी विच इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑन अनदर फिजिकल क्वांटिटी एंड सच क्वांटिटी कैन मेजर्ड डायरेक्टली, सो कॉल्ड एज बेसिक क्वांटिटी. अनदर type of physical quantity will be seen, that is derived quantity, derived physical quantity. So it is defined as the physical quantity which depends on another physical quantity. Called derived quantity or derived physical quantity. Means the quantity which depends on another physical quantity called derived physical quantity. Derived physical quantities, some examples are area, volume, density, velocity, acceleration, force, etc. These physical quantities are depends on another physical quantity, such as we know area, it will be length and breadth, their product. So product of length and breadth will be said to be area. Again, volume, it will be product of length, breadth and height. It gives volume. Length, breadth and height gives volume. So this derived quantity is measured and expressed derived physical quantity or derived quantity is measured or expressed in terms of one or more basic or fundamental quantity. Like we know area will be the product of length and breadth. So length or breadth is measured as length. So we can write as length multiplied by length means length square. So area, its unit will be meter square. Its unit will be meter square, or we can write meter square. But if we know velocity, velocity will be the ratio of distance to time. Distance can be measured as length, so we can write as length time upon time. So we know that length is measured in meter and time is measured in second. So unit for derived physical quantity will be meter per second. Another, the third physical quantity will be supplementary physical quantity. So, in this supplementary physical quantity, it is the angles for its or for measurement of physical quantity is called supplementary physical quantity. Example for some supplementary physical quantities will be solid angle, and another will be plane angle. Means solid angle and plane angle, these are the examples for supplementary physical quantity. Means when we know the three types of physical quantity, one is fundamental physical quantity, another is derived physical quantity, and lastly we can see the supplementary physical quantity. So there are units, will be fundamental units for fundamental quantity, derived units for derived quantity. We know that the fundamental quantity and derived quantity means the unit which can measure the fundamental quantity is called fundamental unit, and the unit which can measure the derived quantity called as derived quantity. But the another term, that is systems of unit, means the whole set of units, that is fundamental units, fundamental unit and derived unit. Are called or are take together, used together, forming or form as systems of unit, named as systems of unit. Means we can see the units fundamental and derived, means the unit which can measure fundamental quantity called as fundamental unit, and unit which can use to measure the derived quantity called as derived unit. But a whole set of unit, that is fundamental unit and derived unit, are taken as or take together to form a systems of unit. So we can see the different types of systems. Systems are there, they are different. So we can see one by one that different types of systems. So first, in 1824, the British Imperial system, that is FPS, means foot pound second. Foot pound second, that is FPS system, which is introduced in universe in 1824. Second will be in 1874, after 50 years, the French metric system will be CGS, that is centimeter gram second. The French metric CGS system will be centimeter gram second system, which is introduced after 50 years in 1874. In 1889, a metric system MKS, that is meter kilogram second system, is introduced after 15 years from 1874. After 15 years, in 1889, a metric system, MKS system, is introduced. And later on, in 1960, means 71 years, after 71 years, a SI system, that is the International Systems of Unit, System of Unit in France can be introduced after 71 years from 1889, when MKS system is introduced. After 71 years, then a SI system is, that is said to be International System of Unit, is introduced in France. And so SI system is accepted universally. Universally, SI system is accepted, which is similar to MKS, means meter kilogram second system. Whole universe can accept a system named as SI system. In MKS system, It went through several revision before its last version. So here RMKSA means rationalized. Meter, kilogram, second and ampere. System is introduced in 1946. Also adopted in SI system. Also adopted in SI system. So we can see some rules for writing the unit. Rules for writing unit. Rules for writing unit. So here firstly we have seen unit should not write in full form. Full form. After a person means if we say the unit for force that is 10 newtons, so we can write 10 newton. So we cannot write full form, but it can be write as it can be not write full form, but it is written as it can be write as 10 newton. Here we cannot write as 10 kilogram meter per second square. It can be written as 10 kilogram meter per second square. Can be written as 10 kg meter per second square. Second thing, unit names including those derived quantity or derived form of unit. Proper names are written in lower case, means unit should not write in capital letter. Example, after first. Example, 3 meter not राइट, इट इज रिटन एज 3 meters और 3 meter means full form of unit always write with small letter as Newton, Joule, Farad, Hertz, Coulomb, etc. Third rule will be symbol for the units named after a person are in capital letter. We can see above, that is capital N for Newton, capital J for Joule, capital F for Farad, etc. Fourth rule will be symbols for other units are written in small letter. Example, for meter, M, for kilogram, kg, for second, S. These are the symbols for other units. And lastly, unit should write only in singular form. Means unit should not write in plural forms. Example, mass will be 10 kg, not written as 10 kgs. These are the rules for writing a unit. We can determine some units in fundamental quantity as well as derived quantity. See here, fundamental quantity, SI units, symbols. If we can see a table, that table shows different types of fundamental quantities, its unit and symbol. So first, the unit for fundamental quantity will be length. Its SI unit is meter and its symbol will be meter. Second, mass. SI unit for mass is kilogram and symbol will be kg. Third, time. SI unit for time is second. Symbol will be S. Electric current. SI unit for electric current is ampere. And symbol for ampere is capital A. So, another quantities, fundamental quantities will be there as temperature. SI unit of temperature is degree Kelvin or Kelvin. And symbol for unit of temperature will be K. Sixth quantity, that is luminous intensity. And SI unit for luminous intensity will be candela. And symbol for candela will be CD. Again, the seventh fundamental quantity will be amount of substance. SI unit for amount of substance will be mole. But symbol for amount of substance will be MOL, mole. These are the units for fundamental quantity. Similarly, for supplementary quantity, two supplementary quantities are there. One will be plane angle and another will be solid angle. So, we can see supplementary quantity, SI unit and symbol. Supplementary quantity is plane angle. Its SI unit is radian and symbol will be RAD. Second supplementary quantity is solid angle. SI unit is steradian and its symbol will be. So, SI unit for solid angle is steradian and symbol will be SR. Similarly, we can find out some units for derived quantity. SI units for derived quantities. We know that if area is given, so area will be defined as length multiplied by breadth. Length is measured as breadth, or breadth is measured as length. So area is equal to length multiplied by length, that is equal to length square. And the SI unit for length, it will be meter. So SI unit for area is will be meter square. Again, we can find out SI unit for velocity. So velocity having a formula, ratio of distance or displacement to the time. Here distance is measured as length. So velocity, SI unit of velocity is length multiplied by time. So SI unit of velocity will be, length is measured in meter and time is measured in second, that is meter per second. Again, the third example will be force. If we can find out SI unit of force, so formula for force will be product of mass into acceleration. Here mass will be fundamental quantity, but acceleration will be derived quantity, having formula velocity upon time. In this formula we can see that time is fundamental quantity, but velocity is a derived quantity. It may be written as mass upon time multiplied by distance upon time, because ratio of distance upon time will be velocity. So force is written in fundamental quantity will be mass multiplied by distance upon time square. So SI unit of force will be, mass is measured in kilogram, distance is measured in meter, and time square will be measured in second square, will be kg meter per second square or newton. Similarly, we can find out various types of SI unit of derived quantity. But here we have to solve using another formulas. For more practice, you can solve the questions from a given assignment. For more practice.